Hello all, in this video we are going to compare indirect file loading in Informatica versus SSIS. Now to do that we are going to load two different CSV files, that is employees and employees2.csv into a relational target employees2. We have totally five records, three records in employees CSV files and two records in employees2 CSV files. And these five records from these two different files we are going to load in a target table employees2, which has same columns, ID, first name, last name, city and company, and the only extra column which we have, file path, just to identify these records belongs to which particular file. Now to start with, we'll create a Informatica mapping first. I have already imported source and target. We'll directly create the mapping. Create indirect file load. Source is flat file and target is relational table employees2, and the extra column is the file path, and to get the file name or the file path we have to go to source definition. And we just have to check this checkbox, add currently processed flat file name port. Once you check that option, automatically one extra port will appear here. Just pull that port till source qualifier, and now we have all the five columns available. Just connect that to target. So our mapping is created. That is also in valid state. Just create the corresponding workflow. We have created workflow as well. Just define connections for that workflow. Indirect file load. And since we are doing indirect file load, just change the source file type as indirect. Change the source directory to the main directory, and source file name we are going to give this file list which has actual file names which we are supposed to load. So just take the file list name, which will be an actual input to our Informatica source, and target is relational table to SQL Server. Let's check the connection again, ORCL, and this is the server name. Just truncate the target table just to verify there are no old records available there. Workflow is also in valid state. Just execute the workflow. Bear with me, my PC is little slower. It will take some time. Yeah, the mapping is running. It's supposed to read five records, three records from first file and two records from other file, and supposed to insert five records at target table along with the file name, which is the extra column at our target table. Yeah, so as expected, it has read five records and same five records got inserted. Just check in the target table now. Yes, so three records from the first file and two records from the second file. Now same thing we are going to perform using SSIS. Just truncate this table again. So this table doesn't have any records now. Open the SSIS Visual Studio. create simple SSIS project. Pull the data flow task. Since our source is flat file, pull the flat file source, create the connection, just take any file, we'll take employees.csv file first, define the columns, ID. So one thing, our file doesn't have header information, so we are going to read from first file, that is from first record itself, which is our actual data. So just define first is ID, second is first name, third column is last name, fourth column is city, and the last column is company. Done. Just preview it. Yeah, it appears correctly. Now our target is relational table. Pull the ADO.NET destination. Create a new connection. Target table is employees.to. Preview it, it doesn't have any records. Define the mappings. Since source and target column names are same, it got connected automatically. Now we have to read that file indirectly. We have to basically read the data from two different files. So pull for each loop container, define collection as for each file emulator, go to that fold respective folder name, that is my work Informatica problems, and we have to read only CSV files. Define the variable name, that is file name. And that is a fully qualified, so the variable file name will have entire path of that file, entire actual physical path, and pull this data task in that for loop container. So how many CSV, so this data flow task will run that many times, how that may like, since we'll delete these CSV files because this doesn't have actual data, we just created this for Informatica indirect loading purpose. So now it has only two CSV files. So because of this for loop container, our data flow task will run for two times because there are two CSV files. Now we also have to add current processing file name. So in order to add that derived column, pull the derived column transformation and pull our variable which has actual value of our currently processing file name. And if you see, this is the Unicode DTR WSTR data type which we have to cast in string data type. So in order to do that, just pull dt string data type, length just define as 100 and code page just define as 1532. This information you can easily get in MSDN library itself. So just this is the function for casting, and this is the byte code page 1252. So I will change this again to 1252. Yeah, now that error has gone. Done. Now just define currently processing file name as well. Have to do another setting. Go to the properties, expression. Here you have to define connection string as actual file name or actual fiscal path. Done. Execute the package. If you go to data flow flask, it has read two rows in the sense there are two files, so it ran for twice. If you see, it has five records, three records as expected from first file and two records as expected from the second file. Thank you for watching this video.